Hi everyone, I'm Claire.
And I'm John.
And today we're talking about sleep habits. Clearly a title of an article you understand. It's about sleep habits.
Yeah.
Now, before you jump to conclusions, no, we haven't talked about this before. There has been an article in the past, but this is about the latest research. So don't click away, stay with us. We've got some new info for you.
I'm glad you remember. This all seemed new to me.
So before we get there into the article, let's just go over the basics.
Okay.
John, and you guys, how many hours do you sleep per night, usually?
You know what, now I'm remembering, because I remember answering this question. I would rate my sleep very poorly, but my hours slept would be average of 5.5 to 5.
That is quite low.
Yeah.
Average.
Yeah, not my happiest moment every day.
Do you feel like you're the kind of person who wakes up super early and can't get back to sleep, or do you struggle to get to sleep at night?
I struggle to get to sleep at night.
Yeah. Okay, so same as me then. So you've probably at least asked yourself this question. What are some ways to fall asleep faster?
Quite often In fact, when I listen to people talking about their insomnia and how they blah, 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 I start to try and use those same tactics and everything like that. It's weird. I don't know why this works, but one that works for me, just for me, is imagining a certain circumstance and focusing on that one circumstance while I'm imagining it, I'll fall asleep quicker for some reason. If I start thinking about real world stuff, no. Mm. I'm talking about like, what if I were going to live to 1,000 years old? And then I start thinking about that, fall asleep quicker. The other one is systematically relaxing your muscles intentionally. I've been practicing that, but it has made me sleep less tensely. Mm. But I don't think it has helped me fall asleep faster.
Nice.
It is a good practice, though.
I like that one. They call it the body scan.
Oh.
So like you mentally imagine your body being scanned and you gradually sort of, yeah, relax all the muscles all the way down the body.
I'm pretty sure I learned it from you. And I've been doing it since that article.
You see?
When you said the body scan, I was like, I think that's where it was from.
We're learning more than English.
Yes. At least I am.
Useful skills. Me too. So let's see what useful tips and tricks and ideas we can pick up from the latest sleep research. Read the article or just the summary, and we'll see you in part two.
Sleep habits. Adequate sleep is crucial for good health, but it's often neglected. Recent research shows that the quality of one's sleep is especially important. People who have regular sleeping hours and a proper sleeping environment can get by on fewer hours than those with erratic and poor quality sleep. Going to bed and waking up at the same time every day is very helpful. Screen time should be eliminated or reduced around bedtime, as should eating and vigorous physical activity. Instead, a relaxing bedtime routine should be followed.